Hi there.
In this video, we'll be talking about optimizing our preferences for a better workflow in InDesign, so let's get started. You'll find the preferences option on a PC under Edit menu somewhere towards the end, and on a Mac, it sits under InDesign, so let's click General. The first one is this option that says Show Home Screen when no documents are open. If you find the welcome screen confusing and want to straight away land to the screen from where you can select the new document, you can uncheck this box. So next time you double-click the InDesign icon, you'll land here. And from here, you can then go to File and then New and click Document to create a new document and then hit Create. Since I love my welcome screen, I'd check the box. The next one is this Content Aware Fit option. By default, it is unchecked, and let me show you what it does. Let's grab a rectangle frame tool and make a rectangular frame here. Now let's go to File, and then Place, and locate an image on the computer, and then hit Open. Once your image is placed into the frame, you'll find that it's not the complete image, so particularly when I'm working on a document where I have to place lots of images, it's better to have the Content Aware Fit option checked. So let's undo the last action and go to Preferences and then General and check the Content Aware Fit option and hit OK. Now let's go to File and then Place and locate the same image on the computer and hit Open. And you shall find that this time the image has been placed perfectly into the frame. Please be aware that this is still not the entire image. Let's right-click and go to Fitting and select Fit Content to Frame option. And you shall find the image resizing itself slightly. So what Content Aware Fit does is, it automatically scales and repositions the image into the frame based on the context and focal point of the image, which is why the subject is enhanced and the unnecessary corners are shared using Content Aware Fit. Let's move on to the next one. Let's go to the Interface tab under Preferences. From here, you can change the color theme of InDesign. If you prefer a darker theme, select the one on the left. If you prefer a lighter theme, you have two nice options to choose from, so it's entirely up to your choice here. I'm going to stick to the default option. The next one is Units and Increments, so let's move to that tab. And in here, the ruler units are set to picas, so let's change it to millimeters and hit OK. And the rulers will be set to a more familiar unit. You can choose millimeters or inches or centimeters depending upon your comfort zone with them. For the next one, let's make a rectangle using the rectangle tool. Now, when you click and move it, it moves in certain preset increments. If you want to reduce or increase the size of the increments, go to Preferences and then Units and Increments. And you see at this point, it is set to 0.353 millimeter, which means with every click, it moves 0.353 millimeter. So let's change it to 0.1 millimeter and hit OK. And now when you move it using the arrow keys, it will move as per 0.1 millimeter increments. It's an option used more when precision is required in terms of alignment. Let's move on to the next one, and it's spelling. Here you can check Enable Dynamic Spelling option, and it shall work much like the spell checker of MS Word. Now, if you move on to autocorrect, you'll find quite a few misspelled word lists on the left and their correction on the right. So basically, this is for people that have a trend in misspelling words. So instead of typing in about, they tend to type in A-double-B-O-U-T, so InDesign corrects it when it comes across a word like this. But you'll have to add such words to the list for it to trigger a correction. So let's hit OK and see how it works. Let's select the Type tool and make a text box. Let's type in A-double-B-O-U-T, and the moment you enter another space, InDesign will trigger correction. You may also have noticed the green underline, and that's because we have activated dynamic spelling. So InDesign will give you red lines under incorrect spellings and green lines if the sentence is incomplete. Now you see if I type in A-B-O-O-U-T, it's an incorrect spelling of the word about. So InDesign has alerted us with the red underline, but it hasn't auto-corrected the word. because we never added this word to be auto-corrected. So let's add it now. Let's go to the autocorrect option and click the add button. In the misspelled word bar, type in A-B-O-O-U-T, and in the correction bar, add the right spelling of the word and hit OK and come out of the preferences panel. Now, if you misspell the word about adding two O's, InDesign will autocorrect it. Let's misspell the word favorite and you shall find the red underline. Correct it and the underline will be replaced with green. It's because it's a standalone word. It will not happen if you type in a complete sentence. Let's type in I love Adobe. And you shall find no green underline. Let's delete the text and get back to preferences. Let's move to clipboard handling, and we have already covered this option earlier during one of the tutorial sessions, but let's discuss it once more. So this one is particularly useful when you're pasting text or tables from other applications. So if you want them to come to InDesign along with the styles and swatches, etc., you should choose the all information option from here. Else you can select the text only option, in which case you'll have to style everything on InDesign as per your choice. Do go through other options in preferences and see what you can further customize according to your working style and something you feel can add on to your workflow efficiency. And I'm sure it will speed up your work and make life simple for you. All right, guys, that concludes our session and I'm going to see you in the next one momentarily. Goodbye.